హలో ఎవ్రీవన్, వెల్కమ్ టు అవర్ ఛానల్. దిస్ ఈజ్ పాషా. లెట్ అస్ స్టార్ట్ అవర్ టుడేస్ క్లాస్. నేమ్ ఆఫ్ ద చాప్టర్ ఈజ్ లైన్స్ అండ్ యాంగిల్స్. ఇన్ దిస్ క్లాస్ వీ ఆర్ గోయింగ్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ ఎ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ కాన్సెప్ట్, ట్రాన్స్వర్సల్ అండ్ యాంగిల్స్ మేడ్ బై ఏ ట్రాన్స్వర్సల్. వాట్ ఈస్ ఎ ట్రాన్స్వర్సల్? ఎ లైన్ విచ్ ఇంటర్సెక్ట్స్ టూ ఆర్ మోర్ లైన్స్ ఎట్ డిస్టింక్ట్ పాయింట్స్ ఈస్ కాల్డ్ ఎ ట్రాన్స్వర్సల్. హియర్ అబ్జర్వ్ దిస్. Here line L and another line M, they both are intersected by P. Now P is a transversal to the line L and M. A line which intersects two or more lines at distinct points is called a transversal. Here P is a transversal to the line L and M. Now here there are total 8 angles are formed: angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8. In each intersection there are 4 angles formed. In total there are total 8 angles are formed when a transversal cuts the two lines at distinct points. Now here angle 1, angle 2, angle 7, angle 8 are exterior angles. Here, angle 1, angle 2, angle 1, angle 2, angle 7 and angle 8 are exterior angles because they are outside the two lines. Next, interior angles. Here, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6. Angle 3, angle 4, angle 5 and angle 6 are interior angles because they are inside the two lines or in between the two lines. Next, vertically opposite angles. What are vertically opposite angles? When two lines intersect each other, the angles formed, okay, at the point of intersection, the opposite to each other are called vertically opposite angles. Here angle 1 opposite to angle 3, these two are vertically opposite angles. And angle 2 and angle 4 are vertically opposite angles. Let us write the pairs of vertically opposite angles. Angle 1, angle 3 are vertically opposite angles. Next, angle 2, angle 4 are vertically opposite angles. Next, angle 5, angle 7 and angle 6, angle 8. These are the pairs of vertically opposite angles. There are total 4 pairs of vertically opposite angles. Next, let us observe corresponding angles. What are corresponding angles here? Here angle 1, angle 5, angle 2, angle 6. Next, angle 4, angle 8 and angle 3 and angle 7 are the pairs of corresponding angles. Angle 1, 5. Angle 1 comma angle 5. Next to angle 2 comma angle 6. Next, angle 4, 8. Angle 4 comma angle 8. Next to and angle 3, angle 7. These are the pairs of corresponding angles. Next to alternate interior angles. Here angle 3, angle 5, angle 4, angle 6. Alternate interior angles. Here what are alternate interior angles? Angle 3, angle 5, angle 4, angle 6. Here angle 3, angle 5. Next to angle 4, angle 6. Angle 4, angle 6 are the pairs of alternate interior angles. Similarly, angle 1, angle 7, next angle 2, angle 8 are the pairs of alternate exterior angles. These are the pairs of angles formed when a transversal cuts two lines at two distinct points. What happens to these angles when the given two lines are parallel? If a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, let us observe the angles. Here, for example, the line L and M are parallel lines, and P is a transversal which intersects this line at L and M at distinct points. Again, there are 8 angles formed: angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7, and angle 8. Let us observe a window. Let us observe a window or a graph paper. Here, it is a transversal and these two parallel lines are intersected by a transversal. Here again, look at this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and 8 angles formed. Observe these two angles, 1 and 5 and 4 and 8, corresponding angles, they are equal. Corresponding angles are equal. So now we can say that if a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the angles in each pair of corresponding angles are equal. Corresponding angles equal. Corresponding angles equal. Corresponding angles equal. Here corresponding angles, angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Next to angle 2 is equal to angle 6. Next, angle 4 is equal to angle 8. And angle 3 is equal to angle 7. These corresponding angles equal. Next to alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. Let us observe one example here. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Because since vertically opposite angles. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. These two are vertically opposite angles. Next to angle 1 is equal to angle 5. Since corresponding angles. So from this both the cases we can also write that angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Angle 3 is equal to angle 5. So these two are equal. Alternate interior angles equal. We can say that when a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the angles in each pair of alternate interior angles equal. Alternate interior angles equal. Alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles equal. Alternate interior angles equal. Here angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Next, angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Now, let us observe angles on the same side of the transversal. Here, the line L parallel to M. Here, angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees. Angle 3 plus angle 4 is equal to 180 degrees. Why? Since they form a linear pair of angles. Next to here angle 3 is equal to angle 5. Angle 3 is equal to angle 5. They are since alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles. From this both the cases, from these two cases we can write angle 3 is equal to angle 5. So we can write it as angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degrees. Angle 4 plus angle 5 is equal to 180 degrees. Nothing but when if a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the angles in each pair on the same side of the transversal measures 180 degrees are supplementary. Now we can conclude that if a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the angles in each pair of corresponding angles equal. Angle 1, 5 equal. Angle 2 is equal to angle 6. Next to angle 4 is equal to angle 8. Angle 3 is equal to angle 7. Then each pair of alternate interior angles equal. Angle 3 is equal to 5. Angle 4 is equal to angle 6. Then each pair of alternate exterior angles also equal. Angle 1 is equal to angle 7. Angle 2 is equal to angle 8. So we can conclude that if a pair of parallel lines are intersected by a transversal, then the angles in each pair of corresponding angles equal. Next, alternate interior angles equal, alternate exterior angles equal,
angles on the same
and
side
of the transversal measures 180 degrees are supplementary. Okay, let us observe another example. Here, these two are the parallel lines, angle L and angle M are the parallel lines. L parallel to M, and next to P is a transversal, and next here angle 1, angle 2, angle 3, angle 4, angle 5, angle 6, angle 7 and angle 8. Let angle 1 80 degrees. If angle 1 is equal to 80 degrees, then find all other angles in a transversal. Here angle 1 is equal to 80 degrees. As we know that angle 1 plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees since linear pair. Here substitute this angle 1, 80 degrees here. Angle 80 degrees plus angle 2 is equal to 180 degrees. Next, angle 2 is equal to 180 degree minus 80 degree, which is equal to 100 degrees. Here angle 2 is equal to 100 degrees. As sum of these two angles, angle 1 plus angle 2, they form a linear pair, and sum of these two angles is 180 degrees. 100 plus 80 degrees is 180 degrees. As we know that here vertically opposite angles equal. Angle 1 is equal to angle 3. Angle 1 measures 80 degrees. Angle 3 also 80 degrees. And angle 2, angle 4 vertically opposite angles. Angle 4 also 100 degrees. Now here, if you observe the corresponding angles, angle 1 and angle 5 are also equal 80 degrees, and angle 2, angle 6, they are equal angle 6, it measures 100 degrees. Now again angle 6 and 8 are vertically opposite angles, angle 8 it measures 100 degrees, and angle 7 and angle 5 are vertically opposite angles.